Arab again at the short traitors and a comfortable, full sinful riches wherein I may have a great solace and comfort to him and understanding the he and unspeakable mercy of our sovereign Savior Christ Jesus, whose name be worshipped and magnified without an end. But now in our days to us unworthy deneath to exercise his noble and his goodness, all the works of our Savior being with our example and instruction on what grace that he worketh in any creature is all profit, if lack of charity be not all hindrance. And therefore, by the labour of all merciful Lord Christ Jesus, to the magnifying of his holy name, Jesus, this little treatise shall threaten some day in parcel of his wonderful works, how mercifully, how benignly, and how charitably he mired and stirred a sinful caitiff unto his love, righteous sinful caitiff, many various was in will and in purpose, thou stirring of the Holy Ghost in following our Savior, making great behastes of fastings with many other deeds of penance, on every sesh was turned again back in time of temptation, late unto the red spear, which bowed with every wand, and never is stable less than no wind bloweth, unto the time that our merciful Lord Christ Jesus, having pity and compassion of his handwork and his creature, turned health into sickness, prosperity into adversity, worship into reproof, and love into hatred, thus all these things turning upside down, this creature which many verdes had gone well and ever been unstable, was perfectly drawn and stirred to enter in the way of he perfection which paleth why Christ our Savior is his proper persona exempling. Sadly he tried it, and darly he went in befall. Than these creature of whom these traitors fall, the mercy of Jesus shall shorten in part of the living touched by the hand of our Lord with great bodily sickness, wherever shall lost reason and how wait us a long time till our Lord be Christ restored her again as it shall more openly be showered afterward. Our worldly goddess, rich were plenteous and abundant at that day, in little wheel after were full barren and barer than some pompa and preda cast down and lie down cedar. Thy that befell in hard worship it have seeth and full sharply reproved hell. A kindred on thy that had been friendless were now hell most enemies. Then she, considering this wonderful jonging, seeking succour under the ranks of her ghostly mother holy church, went and obeyed her to her ghostly father, accusing herself of her misdeeds and seething dead great bodily penance, and in short time our merciful Lord who've steed his creature with plenteous studies of contrition bay, and so much that some men sighed and she mixed the weep and one she walled unslandered the walk of gold. She will so used to be slandered and reproved, to be chidden and rebuked of the world for grace and virtue with which she was endowed for the strength of the Holy Ghost, that it was to her in the manner of solace and comfort, when she suffered any dice for the love of God, and for the grace that God wrought in her, for ever the more slander and reproof that she suffered, the more she ascribed in grace and in devotion of holy meditation, of e contemplation, and of wonderful speeches and dalliance, which our Lord spake and dallied to her soul, teaching her how she should be displayed for his love, how she should have patience, setting all her trust, all her love, and all her affection in him only. She knowa and understood many sacred and private things which should befallen afterward by inspiration of the Holy Ghost, and often times well she was kept with such holy speeches and dalliance she showed us so weeping and sobbing that many men were greatly a wonder, for thy wasting full little how homely over Lord was in her soul. Nay, herself could never tell of the grace that she felt. It was so heavenly, so he above in her reason, and her bodily weakness and her body so feeble in time of presence of grace that she might never express yearning with her word leech as she felt it in her soul. Then had this creature made to dread for illusions and deceits of her ghostly enemies, than one shared the bidding of the Holy Ghost to the worshipful clerk as both our bishopes, doctors of divinity, and bachelors also. She spoke also with many anchors and showed at him her manner of living and switch grasa, as the Holy Ghost of his goodness rocked in her mind and in her soul, as her rector would serve in her to express in it. And they all that she shouted her satiris unto side a shy was major bonded to love our Lord for the grace that he shouted unto her and counseled her to the following her mangis and her staringus, and trustly believing it wherein of the Holy Ghost and of none evil spirit. Some of this worthy and worshipful clerkers talking it peril of her soul, and as they would answer to God that this creature was inspired with the Holy Ghost, and more than her that she showed on him written and marking a book of her Felingus and her revelations. Soon preferred her to written her Felingus with her own handes, and she would not consenting in no way, for she was commanded in her soul that she should not written so soon, and so it was 20 years and more for that time this creature had first feelings and revelations ere than she did any written. Afterward, when it pleased our Lord, he commanded her and charged her that she should it on written her feelings and revelations in the form of her livings, that his goodness may be known to all the world. Then had the creature no rita that would fulfill her desire, ne gaia credence to her fellingas, unto the team that a man dwellinga in Deutschland, rich was an Englishman in his birth, and seethed and waited in Deutschland, and had her both a wife and a child, having good knowledge of this creature and of her desire. Moved, he trusted the Holy Ghost, coming to England with his wife and his goddess, and dwelled with the foresighted creature till he had written as much as she would, telling him for the time that they were together.